if you've been in Pennsylvania for a decent amount of time, chances are pretty good that you have crossed paths with a skunk.
It's happened, but when do you have the biggest chance of getting skunked? Here's News 8's naturalist Jack Hubley with tonight's wild moment.
If you live in the Susquehanna Valley, have a backyard, a deck, and or a shed, well, sooner or later, you're probably going to have striped skunks. Skunks love the prospect for worms, grubs, and other insects in turf grass, and they love dry, secure den sites beneath buildings. Oh, yes, they also love to see what's inside your trash bags. Skippy here isn't a problem. He's a socially acceptable skunk with his ammunition permanently removed. But as many of you know, a wild, fully loaded skunk can really ruin your day, especially if your dog has the run of the yard at night. And that's what worries Leanne Ressler. She writes, "Seems there's more black and white sightings this year, and I'm not talking about police cruisers. We saw and smelled skunks at least 5 times a week. Is there any time of year when we can relax and our dog can safely explore outside?" Yes, Leanne, there is a time when you can relax, sort of, and that time is now. Skunks don't hibernate in the true sense of the word. They don't experience the dramatic drop in body temperature and heart rate that groundhogs do. But they will den up for weeks or even months at a time during the winter, especially during severe weather. You're least likely to see them out and about in January. So enjoy this brief skunkless period while it lasts, because mating season starts next month. Beginning about mid-February, male skunks surface and travel from den to den, searching for eligible females. All this traveling, of course, brings skunks to busy roads. And that's why Valentine's Day isn't necessarily a holiday for skunks looking for love. So, Skippy, there are advantages to living the sheltered life of the official News 8 skunk. I'm Jack Hubley, News 8.
Oh, we'll protect you. Well, Jack says some people think if you pick a skunk up by the tail, it cannot spray. But Jack says, better not count on that. If you have a wildlife question for Jack, email it to news8@wgal.com and you may see your answer on the air.